We have prayed. Like I said, we prayed shortly on grace. In Romans 5:17 says, for if by the trespass of one death reigned through the one, much more shall they that they receive the abundance of grace and of the gift of the righteousness reign in life through one, even Jesus Christ. So death came through one, and by the grace of God, abundant grace of God, we have the power of righteousness, of resurrection through the one, Jesus Christ. And we are going to pray this morning that the Father God of grace, let that grace abound for me. Let the abundant grace be upon me. Abundant grace, let it be upon us. Abundant grace, let it be for us. In the name of Jesus. Please lift up your voice and pray for grace of God to be upon you. In the name of Jesus. Our Lord and our God, we come before you. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray that let the river of grace, oh God, flow freely in our lives, oh God, today, in our family. The river of grace, abundant grace, sounding grace, let it flow through us today, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we pray for the abundant grace of God to rise in us, in the name of Jesus. The unexpected, unmerited favor through the grace of God showered into our lives in the name of Jesus. Let it show in our lives, oh God. Let it show in our family in the name of Jesus. Help us, oh Lord. Help us, our Father. Help us, Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. Please, Lord, wherever, oh God, we have been neglected, let the grace reconnect us. Wherever we've been cast out, oh God, let the grace of God help us. In the mighty name of Jesus. Glory to your holy name. Thank you, Father, for your rich love upon our lives. Thank you, Jesus, for you are awesome. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Let's go quickly look at the book of Luke. We look at the book of Luke 19, and we see how grace worked for one man there. And the man, we know the story very well. And we just use that to pray this morning. And it said, Jesus entered Jericho and made his way through the town. Praise the Lord. When Jesus enter, wherever you are, Jesus will enter in the name of Jesus. There was a man named me, or named you. Let's put it that way. And I want us to twist it a bit to favor us this morning. He was a tax collector in the region. And he had become very rich. So he's not an ordinary man. He is very rich. Let's take notes. The man have enough, but there's something missing in his life. The man had money, but money did not give him joy. And the Bible said, he tried to look at Jesus, just like you and I in some situation. We try and we want to see God to move in this area of our lives. We keep looking, we keep asking God. And the Bible said, but he was too short to see over the crowd. There's some area in our lives when we get there, we are too short to get to where we want to go to. But there is solution and there is a way. And that way is Jesus. And it has worked for those of the past. It will work for you and I in the name of Jesus. Amen. And the Bible said, but he was too short to see over the crowd. So he ran ahead and climbed a sycamore fig tree beside the road. Take some of these trees when you go to Jerusalem, when you have this tour and a good tour, he will show you some of these trees there, because we were there, me pastor could witness it. The trees over, like God knows how many over 1,000 years old, is still there. And he said, when Jesus came by, he looked up at Zacharias and called him by name. Zacharias, he said, come. Zacchaeus, come. Quick, come down. I must be a guest in your home today. Let us pause there and pray to God. Where are you too short to see over the crowd? Pray that God will give you the grace to run ahead and do the right thing. The only solution for him so that he can meet Jesus, the faith he had then was, if I run ahead and climb a tree because of my shortness, I will see Jesus. All his expectation was to see Jesus. But Jesus had a greater package for him. And he said, today, he will be with him. Pray that God will be with us in his majesty's sanctuary. Everywhere we are shut, oh God, we cannot see ahead. Pray that God will come in and move us ahead in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Let's lift up our voice and pray. As you pray for the church, you are praying for your family. Put it parallel like that. In the name of Jesus. Father, this is where we are. This is our problem. This is our situation. We need the intervention, oh God. As we intervene in the life of Cyrus, oh God, help us, oh God, and intervene in our lives in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we are running ahead. We are looking unto you, the author and finisher of our faith. This is our situation. Let grace advance for us, oh God, as you ask, as you was for Christ, in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, lead us into the root of grace, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Lead us into the root of grace, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Help us, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Glory to your holy name. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. The Bible said, when he gets to the tree, he looked up and called upon him, come down, today I must be in your house. Father, today, not tomorrow, today. This is, see, when God is in your house, brethren, then there is no more difficulty. There is no more problems. It doesn't matter how big the problem may be. It doesn't matter how small it may be. When Jesus stepped into your house, into a place, we know what happens there. There is solution. There is answer. Let us pray this morning that, Father, in today, this morning, in His Majesty's sanctuary, we want to see you. In my family, I want to see you. In the life of my children, Father, manifest yourself. In the life of this area, that brother, that person, oh Lord, manifest yourself. In the name of Jesus, it's not about what you have achieved. It's not about what you have. This man is rich. This man is a tax collector. He is rich according to the word of God. But there is something he still needs. He wants Jesus to move in his life. Father, Lord, this is our life. In the name of Jesus, pray that God will step into your situation. God will step into your family. In that life of that children, or that brother or sister, that God will move. God will move. God will move. God will step in. In the name of Jesus, the grace of God, we do not deserve it, but because of the grace of God, because of His love that He has for us, oh God, is an unmerited favor. In the name of Jesus, He will step in, oh Lord. In Jesus' name, He will step in, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. To you be all the glory. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. The Bible said He came down, took Jesus into His house in a great excitement and joy. In the name of Jesus. Father, please, oh Lord, let there be great excitement and joy in this ministry. Let there be great excitement and joy in my family. Lift up our voice and let us begin to pray in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, are we expecting something from the Lord Almighty? Let there be great excitement and joy in our lives, in His Majesty's sanctuary, in every member, those who are here, those who are not here, oh Lord, wherever they are, in the name of Jesus. Everywhere you go, the Bible said you will be a light, a carrier of glory. In the name of Jesus, you are a chosen one. Father, Lord, let there be excitement and joy in my life, in my family, in my brothers, in my sisters. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Lord. For in Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. For in Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. He said, my wife Christ stood before the Lord and said, I will give half my wealth to the poor, Lord. And if I have cheated people on their taxes, I will give them back four times as much. Jesus responded. See what this man is doing. He tried to punish himself that this is what he is doing. But Jesus replied to him, salvation has come to this house today. Amen. See what I said? Salvation has come to this house today. Amen. Let's pause there and pray. Father, let salvation come to this house today. Amen. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let salvation come to every church calling the name of God in truth and spirit. I'm not talking about Zamborimbo church. I'm not talking about church that kicks and punishes. Father, church that calls the name of Jesus in truth and in spirit. Let salvation come. As many that have not known Jesus, let their hearts be touched, oh God. Let salvation come. We use His Majesty Sanctuary. Use your family, the Father, Lord, today, not tomorrow. As your word has said, salvation has come. Salvation in every area of your life. Salvation in every area of our family. Salvation in every area of the church. In the mighty name of Jesus. Glory to your holy name. Father, we pray. For in Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Amen. He says, for this man has come, showed himself to be the true son of Abraham. For the Son of Man has come to seek and save those who are lost. The Son of Man has come to save and bring back those who are lost. Let us pray to God. Father, please, because of your grace, everywhere I am lost, Father, bring me back. Save me. Everywhere I've gone astray, in the ministry work, in the family, you know, in generality, everywhere I've gone astray. No, God has proposed or God has designed us to be in a certain direction. But we are keep saying that, no, I'm going this direction. Pray this morning that, Father, Lord, today, bring me back. I am here, Father, Lord. Help me, O Lord. Bring me back, O God, where I am lost, O God, on track where you want me to be. Because the way of the Lord is the perfect way. And the way of man leads to destruction. Father, bring me back to the way that you want me to be. The man lost it in the Garden of Eden. But Jesus Christ came to bring us back onto the way. In the name of Jesus, I am going astray. Pray to God this morning that, Father, bring me back to the way. Wherever I am lost, O God, bring me back to the way. In the name of Jesus, help me, O Lord, to come back onto the way of Christ, the way to the cross, in the name of Jesus, the way of Christ, the way to the cross, O God. Father, Lord, you have come to seek me, O Lord. Please, O Lord, let me be obedient to the Spirit of God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let me be obedient to the Spirit of God in the mighty name of Jesus. Let me be obedient to the Spirit of God in the mighty name of Jesus. Lead me, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Bring me back to the way, O Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Bring me back to the way, O Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, O God, I am doing it. Am I doing it wrongly? Please, O God, correct me, Lord. Correct me, Lord. Correct me, Lord. Don't let me go to the way of destruction. Bring me to the way of life, to the way of salvation. Bring us, O God, the church of God, the saint, O God, in the name of Jesus. Don't let it be on that day. Yes, you have done that. Yes, you have done this. But you have not done that. I don't know you. Don't let it be our portion, O Lord. Bring us to the way of salvation, to the way to the cross, to the way to the where your blood was shed and has been shed for us, O God, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for in Jesus' mighty name we are praying. For in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Let's quickly read one more before I go. And that's also in the book of Luke 18. And we start from 35. And see another man, because of grace that God moved in his life, in the name of Jesus. Just like he's going to move in your life and my life, in Jesus' name. Amen. And that's 18, Luke 18, 35. As Jesus approached Jericho, you could see the first one we read, we said Jesus entered. And this one is that Jesus approached. A blind beggar was sitting beside the road. When he heard the noise of a crowd gathering, just like the man that climbed the tree, he asked what was happening. Are you asking, what are they doing there? Or are they asking you, what are they doing there? They told him, Jesus, the Nazarene, is going by. So he began shouting. He began to shout that grace, let it work for me. I need your grace today. Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me. The people rebuke him. Hashtag, they are rebuking today. Just like they are rebuking you. Be quiet. The people in front yelled at him. But he only shouted louder. Today we have made it pockets, children of God. Today we have made it looking unto a particular person. This man did not ignore everything that the people say, but he only shouted louder, Son of David, have mercy on me. When Jesus heard him, he stopped and ordered the man be brought to him. As the man came near, Jesus asked him, what do you want me to do for you? Brethren, Jesus is asking you and I today, what do you want him to do for you? He cried, Lord, he said, I want to see. And Jesus said, all right, receive your sight. Your faith has healed you. Praise the Lord. Instantly, the man could see and follow Jesus. What does he do? Praise him. And all who saw it, praise God too. Let us pray. Anything that wants to sabotage the grace of God in my life, Father, put them to shame. In the name of Jesus, public shame, Father, put them to shame. This man was shouting and people are saying, keep quiet, it's not for you. Anyone that wants to sabotage the grace, the blessing, the joy, the peace, the glory, in the name of Jesus, in His Majesty's sanctuary, in your family, in the life of your children, that says God, they will not get to where they want to go. Father, put them to shame. Answer them by fire. Put them to shame. Make a public disgrace of them. In the name of Jesus. Anyone, oh God, any being, politician, any person that wants to put Christianity to shame, pollute it. Father, Lord, put them to shame. In the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, put them to shame. In the name of Jesus. Put them to shame, oh Lord. In the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, anywhere they are, sitting down in the sitting room, in an office, oh God, designing how to destroy the kingdom of God, Christianity. Oh Lord, persecuting the children of God. Lord, today, we declare, today, in the name of Jesus, confusion, let it enter into their camp. In the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, let confusion enter their camp, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus. Everywhere they are sitting down, designing a destructive thing that wants to destroy the mankind that God Almighty has made in His own image. Father, Lord, oh Lord, we pray this morning, stand still for the children of God and answer our voices, oh Lord, that wherever they are, they're trying to sabotage the glory, the power, the peace that God has put in us, oh God. Put them to shame in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. The Bible said in the book of Hebrews 4:16, let us with confidence draw near to the throne of grace, that we may receive mercy and find grace to help in time of need. If we don't draw near, brethren, and something comes, what is your defense? What is my defense? Let us draw near to receive mercy and find grace to help in times of need. Pray for the abundant grace over us. Pray that the mercy of God will be upon us. Pray that the peace and the mercy of God that passes man's understanding will be upon us. What does this man, does he deserve it? No. But God stood still. And God said, bring him. Call him here. And what? instantly. Not tomorrow, not another day. Instantly. The Bible said he could see. Anywhere Jesus is, there is a solution for somebody. I declare we will receive a solution for one or two or three problems in our lives today, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
The crowd gathered together, brethren, it is amazing. And we can witness it even today. The crowd gathered together. And this woman said, I don't care what anybody says. Even though as a woman, you are not allowed to go there. Much more somebody who's bleeding with blood. But all she wants is the grace of God. That if I could just touch the hem of his garment.
Ah, Baba, you are wonderful.
All she wants is to touch. She did not say, she did not shout. She did not say, hey, Jesus, come and speak to me. Jesus, lay your hands upon me. No. The Bible said, the grace worked for her. Her faith made her whole. Jesus said, power has left me. Power, something different is around me. Who has touched me? They answered him, there are so many people touching you here. Mono, there's something, someone special. Father, pray this morning. Pray with your faith and the grace of God. Is there something in our lives? Something in my life, in your life? Father, today I want to touch you. As this woman has done, let the grace, unmerited favor, abundant favor, let it work for us, oh God. In this church, oh Lord. In our lives, oh God. For that boy, for that girl, for that son, for that daughter, for that sister, for that brother, for that parents, for that son. Hey, that person you are praying for. In the name of Jesus, yeah. Let the healing hand of God, oh Lord, be stretched towards everyone. In the name of Jesus. Let the grace of God, Baba, we pray, Lord, let it work for us, oh God, as it has worked for those of the pastor. In the name of Jesus. Do it again, Father, Lord. We are here, oh Lord. Do it again, Jesus. Yeah. Help us, Lord. Help us, Savior. Help us, King of glory. Help us, everlasting Father. That you alone deserve all the praise. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Just give glory to God. Thank God. Bless his name. Adore him. He's a miracle God. The God of mercy. The God of abundant grace. The God of glory. Thank him for he has done it again. Thank him for salvation has come to us, oh God. Thank him because he has directed us back to the path that we should be. We bless your holy name. Thank God because things will be falling into pleasant places for us, oh God. In the name of Jesus, henceforth, oh God, we begin to see divine direction, divine understanding, divine wisdom in the life of our families, in his ministry, in the life of Christians, oh God, all over the world, in the name of Jesus. Yeah. Father Lord, we come with us. Yeah. We thank you, Father Lord, for your glory, for your miracle. To you be all the glory. We thank you, Jehovah Lord, for in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Everlasting Father, we say thank you.
Thank you, Father.
I am that I am, we give glory back unto you.
Amen.
You are worthy to be praised, Lord Jesus. Thank you for your grace upon our lives. Thank you for the first month, second, third, fourth, and here we are in the fifth month. You kept us, oh God. Within that time and this time, so many have gone. We are not rejoicing over their situation. We go out, our heart goes out for them. But we say, Father, we thank you, Lord. For every one of us that is alive is by your grace and your mercy. And we give all glory back unto you. Father, I pray, accept our thanks in the name of Jesus. As we have prayed this morning, is there any way we have gone astray, prayed wrongly, spoken wrongly, talked wrongly? Father, please, let mercy, oh God, override every one of it, oh Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Teach us how to pray, Father, in Jesus' name. We commit today's service unto your holy hand. From the beginning to the end, in His Majesty's sanctuary, all churches in the world, calling your name in truth and in spirit. Let there be manifestation of your power in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Let the heart of people be touched today. And let there be shout of hallelujah, glory in the kingdom of God, in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Holy Spirit, do what you are supposed to do.
Yes.
Go ahead and take control in Jesus' name.
Yes.
Thank you, Father.
Yes.
For in Jesus' mighty name, we are praying.
Yes.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.